I'm Stuart Shepard. This is Stoplight. It's good to say thank you when someone finally gets it right, even if it takes them a few tries to get there. You probably heard about the teacher in Florida who repeatedly told 12-year-old Giovanni he was not allowed to read a certain book during free reading time. She finally called Giovanni's dad and left this message.
I noticed that he has a book, a religious book, in the classroom. He's not permitted to read those books in my classroom.
So what is that religious book, that banned book, that book not allowed in the classroom? I got a copy right here. It's the Bible, the NIV to be exact. So no Bible in the classroom. Giovanni's father contacted the principal, and the principal said, "Your child is permitted to read the Bible before school, after school, and during lunch in accordance to the law." So no Bible in the classroom. Liberty Institute contacted the school. They were told that only books approved for the Accelerated Reader Program were allowed. So no Bible in the classroom. Except, the attorneys pointed out, the books of the Bible are on that list. Huh. Finally, this letter showed up. The school board of Broward County, Florida does not ban the Bible. It has no such policy and has never made a statement to that effect. But the teacher did, and all the students heard it. And the principal did, and the whole community heard it. And other government employees did, and the whole country heard it. It was only after lawyers got involved that the Bible was cleared of any wrongdoing. And for that, we say, thank you. But how many students do you think will be saying to themselves, "I'm not going to risk getting in trouble by bringing my Bible to school"? There's a lesson here for every Christian student in America. If you don't know your rights, you'll have no rights.